Hi everyone, this is Kishore Chaudhary again with a new video tutorial. So today we are going to go with something called custom domain service in your Azure web app. Well, before getting into it, let me introduce myself again. I am Kishore Chaudhary and I am a C# Corner MVP, and also I am working as a lead training associate in a corporate called CodeSizzler. So we are technical consultants who provide technical trainings to the people across the globe. So coming to the objectives, in the following tutorial we are going to do three different things. The first one is going to be like we are going to purchase a custom domain in our Azure portal, and number two, we shall try purchasing a custom domain in some other third party site, and finally let us map the third party domain which we have purchased in some third party site to our web app service that we would have created in our Azure portal. And again, this following module, again I am not going to have much slides. We are going to jump into the demo. Basically, I am a person who doesn't go with much slides. I love hands-on, and I love to do and show the things in real time, so that's why the number of slides are very less in here. So let us jump into the demo. For demo purpose, you need to have an Azure storage account, I mean like Azure subscription. If you don't have one, do create a free trial. Well, now let's start creating a web app service, and followed by that let us go with the rest of the things. So the first step is to create a web app service so that we can purchase a custom domain for that web app. Click on this create a resource and then go to something called your web plus mobile, or now it will be separated like web and mobile. So you can go to this web in here, and then you can go to this web app. Now give a name for your app service. I'm naming this as CodeSizzler, and it's not available, so let me name it like CodeSizzler demo. Next, let it be Visual Studio Enterprises 0, and next let it be the same resource group, let it be Windows environment. And for app service plan, I have an app service plan in here. Anyway, I'll just create a new service plan, because for this demo we need to have a service plan that supports custom domain. So I'm just going on here and I'm just giving an app service name in here. I name this like my plan, or my plan is enough. And I'll choose location as India, something like South India. And pricing tier, you can see here you have multiple pricing tiers in here. So in the following demo we need to have a virtual machine size, or a pricing tier, or an app service size that supports something called your custom domains. So the best option in here is going to be something like in the development/test environment, you have something called D1 shared infrastructure that supports your custom domain feature. So the best option is to choose this one if in case you are having only custom domain feature enabled in your resource. But now if in case you are going to add an SSL certificate, then the following will not help you, because to add an SSL certificate you have to go for something like B1 series machines, or you can go to shared and there you can production, and there you can go with some standard series. Well, now I will go with this B1 series because I'm gonna add an SSL certificate in the following hands-on. But again, in the another tutorial, that is the next tutorial that I'm gonna do, in that I'll also show you how to add an SSL certificate for your app service. So right now let us just go with this one. So let's choose this B1 series machine in here, and finally let us click on apply, and now let me click on OK. So we have chosen an app service plan with the B1 series. Finally, no need of these application insights, let that be off. Let us pin this to dashboard, and I'm clicking on create. So now my app service plan is getting created along with the web app service. So here the first step has been succeeded, that is creation of your app service with a pricing tier that supports your custom domain feature. Well, let us wait for this deployment to get done. Here we go, the deployment has been succeeded. So we have the overview page in here. Now, this is the first step. So second thing is to add our custom domain. So I told like we have two multiple options here. One is to add your custom domain right from the Azure portal. So let us see that first. In the left side menu of your app service, if you scroll down, you have something called custom domains in here. Go to that. And out in here, you can see you have something like your IP addresses, the host name and everything. If you scroll little down, you will have something called custom domains. So here you can see I have purchased a domain something like kishorechaudhary.com for my site. So forgetting about that, this is a custom domain that is available in here. But again, now imagine that I want to purchase a domain something like codesizzler.demo. So what I can do, I can click on this buy a domain in here, and then let me search for something like CodeSizzler itself. So I'll search for CodeSizzler, and I need to on enter. So you can see here you know that we are searching for a custom domain and we are getting something in here. So some available custom domains have been showed in here. So you can choose the one you need. If in case see, for example, I need something like codesizzler.com, so I will not be provided if that specific domain is not available here. Other than that, I'll be shown with some other options. So that is how you can search for the required domain. And now if suppose I want this codesizzler.org.uk, I can select this, then I can give my contact information, and then I can accept the required privacy options, and finally I can assign this www hostname and the root domain as well, and I need to accept the legal terms. And finally, if I click on OK, a domain will get purchased for me, that is a custom domain will get purchased for me, and it will automatically get assigned to my app service I have in here, right? And the point in here is you have to make sure that the domain that you're going to purchase, it will be purchased for 1 year, so you'll be charged $11.99. So that is $11.99 is going to be the charge that you're going to pay. And once you purchase a domain, you'll be charged for the entire amount. And once after you purchase it, that specific domain, if you go and again delete that domain, then that domain will not be available for the next 3 months. So that is one important thing you have to make sure about. So this is one option where you can go and find your domains and just patch them with this custom domain option in the app service that you have. Well, now I'm not purchasing that one in here because it will cost me charge. So what I do, let's try purchasing a custom domain from some third party site and let us bind that one in here. So here you go, we have a link something like freenome.com. So a freenome.com is a domain service provider. They provide you domain names which you can purchase, and also they give domains at free of cost for testing and development. So you can purchase domains from them at a free of cost for 3 months in that manner. Well, now let us sign in first. So I'm just signing in with my social media account. Now here we go. Let me go to something called services in here, and let me go to something called register a new domain. So here, let me find a domain. So I'll just search for a domain something like Kishore Chaudhary, and I'll click on check availability. You can see here there are multiple domains available in here. So these domains like kishorechaudhary.tk.ml.jacf and gq, they are free of cost. If in case I need a domain called kishorechaudhary.com, it is also available, but the cost is somewhere like $8 in here. So now let's choose this kishorechaudhary.tk, which is free of cost. I'm clicking on get it now, and finally I'm clicking on checkout. So here we go, it's going to be for 3 months at free of cost. You can even take it for a 1 year at free of cost, you can do that. Now I'm just clicking on this continue option in here. So finally I will just complete the purchase. I'll just approve the terms in here and I'll complete the following order. So here we go, we have just completed the order now. Now let's go to this client area in here. Now let's go to this services and something called my domains. This will show me the set of domains that I would have purchased in here. So here we go, we have something like kishorechaudhary.tk. This is what I have purchased now. Let us go to this settings option for managing the DNS of this domain. So here we go, here we have something like manage freenome DNS. Let us click on the same. Now let me say how this works in here. So here I have my Azure subscription, and inside that Azure subscription I have my web app service, and again I have separate site called myfreenome.com, which actually holds a custom domain that I have purchased. Now this freenome site doesn't know that I am the one who is owning the following app service, or this app service doesn't know that I am the one who is owning the following domain name. So now I need to create a kind of authentication stating that I am the owner between these two. So that is why we make use of something like DNS in here. So we need to add a few DNS records in here, so that we will be proving that we are the owner for both these services. So for that, what you need to do is, in place of your DNS management exactly in the following records, first you need to add an aname record. So it's by default, it's here. So in the place of target, you need to give an IP address. So here the IP address is going to be the IP address of your app service. So the following is the IP address of my app service. So for code sizzler demo, this is what the IP address is. I'll come back here and I'll paste the IP address in here, right? So this is an aname record which will point out to the IP address of my app service. So if in case you are doing the same thing in any other third party domain vendor like your GoDaddy or BigRock, in the place of this name you need to add something like @, right? But in freenome you don't need to add this @, because this will show you an error. But in case if it is BigRock or GoDaddy, make sure to add @ in the place of this name. So we have added an aname record. Now let's add one more record. So this one is going to be something like a cname record. So cname record is something called a canonical name record, which will actually point out to www of your site. So now what we have to do is, let's come back in here. So hope you remember the URL of our site is something like codesizzler.codesizzlerdemo.azurewebsites.net. Now what I need to do is, I have to add a cname record. Let the time till we can be same, and in the place of target just put on your URL in here, something like this, that is codesizzlerdemo.azurewebsites.net. Make sure to put this in here. And since it is a cname record, you need to provide something like www in here, which means you can access your website with the URL as www.codesizzlerdemo.azurewebsites.net. Again, we need to add one more record, and again this one is going to be a cname record, and in the place of target you can paste the same DNS URL of your app service, and here just mention something like a verify. So this A verify is for the purpose of again providing an authentication saying that I'm the owner of these two app services. And at last you need to add one more record. So this record is going to be something called a CNAME record. Sorry, it's not a CNAME, but it's a TXT record. So a TXT record is for the purpose of pointing your website without using something like www. So now what you need to do is, in the following place in here, you need to just paste your DNS again, that is your codesizzler.demo.azurewebsites.net, so nothing else. Finally, you can click on save changes in here. Now what happens is, the changes that you have made, that is the DNS records that you have added now, they will get saved in here, and you can see I have a A verify record, a www CNAME record in here, which is pointing to this codesizzler.demo.azurewebsites.net. Again, I have a TXT record, which is pointing to my codesizzler.azurewebsites.net. Right. Now, let us leave it in here. It's done. Let's come back to this one in here. Now, here we go. We have something like add a host name in here. Click on this add a host name. Now, let's use the following domain there. Something like kishorechaudhary.tk. I'm copying this. I'm coming back in here and I'm pasting this kishorechaudhary.tk in here, and now I'll click on this validate. So we can see here this kishorechaudhary.tk is actually an A name record, right? So now it is checking like whether that host name is available or not. So you can see here we have the host name already available, something like host name availability is showing with the green color. And next we need to verify it. That is the ownership. So ownership in the sense like if you are the owner of this custom domain, then you will be having an access to its DNS records, right? So that is what we are doing here. So we need to add the following DNS records in its DNS records place so that you can map these custom domain with your machine, with your app service. So in general this will take some time because DNS propagation will not happen that easily. So we have already added our ANM records and our TXT records. All we need to do is just wait for a few moments and let's click on validate once again. So this process, sometimes it will take some extra time for just proving that your ownership with the domain. So see here, the domain ownership has been proved here. Now let's click on this add host name in here, which means like we have configured a custom domain saying that kishorechaudhary.com for an Azure website, something like codesizzler.demo.azurewebsites.net. You can see here we have changes in here. And again, let us add one more host name, something like www.kishorechaudhary.tk. So this one is for adding another custom domain which can be used to access your website with your prefix called www. Again, let's click on this validate option. So this one is going to be a CNAME record, which is going to be your canonical name record. Now this has been done. Again, you can see here the host name availability and the ownership has been proved in here. Now you can click on this add host name. This is gonna add your host name right in there. Now you can see, just check out this. Here you go with your two different domains that are added. Now let's go to the overview page of this web app and let me browse this one with an URL codesizzler.demo.azurewebsites.net. Okay, I made a mistake. It's codesizzler. So here we go. We have a default site that comes in here. Now what I do, rather than using this master URL, so here the master URL is something like this one, codesizzler.demo.azurewebsites.net. But what I did, I have replaced this master URL with the help of this custom domain called kishorechaudhary.tiki. Now I'll browse for the following here. So when I browse for this kishorechaudhary.tk, I get the same response. Check with this. It's same Kishore Chaudhary, sorry, or something like codesizzler.azurewebsites.net, and again it is same the kishorechaudhary.tk. So both of these sites are actually pointing into the same URL. So that is how you can make your custom domains to come for your websites, so that you can make or you can replace the default names that are provided by Microsoft Azure. So imagine a scenario for this. If suppose you are building an e-commerce site, so let us name that e-commerce site something like xyz.com, or let us say that the e-commerce site or the e-commerce business is named as xyz. So the people of that e-commerce site, they might expect to have their website in a way such that it's something like xyz.com because it's a commerce site. But in Azure you will not get that. In Azure you'll be getting something like xyz.azurewebsites.net. So the best practice in here is to make use of something called a custom domain and purchasing a specific type of custom domain that you need and mapping that into your app service. This will literally make your website to appear in a way such that it will have a specific domain name like this. Hope you are okay with what I did now. Well, let me catch up you people in the next demo where we are gonna add an SSL certificate into our custom domain. Right, now I'm just winding this up. So coming to this, if you have any questions, do write it in the comments section. Do subscribe the channel as well. And you can find me in the Twitter, with the profile ID something like Kishore_1702. And these are my mail IDs, my personal and my company ID. And this one is my website. So you can find me at www.kishorechaudhary.com. And the following is my contact number. So it's even my WhatsApp number. You can write your message anytime you want. Well, let's catch up very soon in the next video tutorial. Thank you all.